All right, tough. All right. A few weeks ago, we told you about a new sharing arrangement at television stations in Chicago. Now it seems the idea is catching on, and WBZ and Fox are the first in Boston to give it a go. They'll start by sharing a helicopter. This week, WBZ and Fox 25 announced a marriage of sorts. They'll be joined at the hip for coverage of run-of-the-mill news conferences, and they'll share just one helicopter.
The crash occurred right by the Burlington Mall there you see on the right.
When local stations in Chicago joined forces several weeks ago, Channel 5 general manager Bill Fine speculated Boston could be next.
It's going to happen potentially in Boston. I hope it doesn't happen with our station included.
So far, Channel 5 is not included, and neither WBZ nor Fox wanted to talk about the deal, which is scheduled to start June 1st. Also on the move?
Well, I will miss you, but I'll see you.
After three decades at WBZ, Liz Walker departed last fall when the station killed Sunday with Liz Walker. Now she'll produce a similar show, Better Living with Liz Walker, slated to air four times a year on Channel 5. And curiously, in the 7:30 Chronicle time slot. The first show airs June 4th. Also rumored to be on the move, Randy Price.
I mean, when we start putting in alligators in Florida on the loose and whatever, you know, firehouse fires in Detroit, I don't think people connect with that.
And Channel 7 decided it didn't connect with Randy Price, cutting him loose in February. But he may be reconnecting at Channel 5. Rumor is he's done an anchor test with the eye-openers Bianca De La Garza. No word on who Price might disconnect over there. First on the news sharing deal, I think my guess is that Bill Fine probably had an inkling that this was going to happen, even though he didn't tell us. But I noticed that today the Washington, D.C. stations announced they're going to do the same thing. I have a feeling this is just going to be infectious, contagious. Everybody's going to start doing it. And while it'll start small here in Boston, I wouldn't be surprised to see if others joined in.
Well, I think it's interesting because, you know, Fox has a helicopter personality in Doug Meehan for their morning show. I'm not aware that Channel 5 has I could be wrong. You know, has a
smart route.
Yeah. No, they have. I know that they use a helicopter, but I don't know that there's a person attached to it as in terms of its personality. So that would seem like, you know, he'd be the one that would end up doing the helicopter thing anyway.
I don't know how the traffic thing's going to work. That's a whole other animal.
Right. But here we have a situation, however, that Fox is non-union and WBZ is union. Now, how do you mesh that? I mean, I understand that people are doing this across the country. There must be coming up someplace else. But I think that's a key thing to think about as they bring that together. Mm. I mean, it makes sense for some things. But again, I'm interested to see if everybody's shooting the same material, how do you make it your own? What is the kind of reporting that happens that, you know, makes you the place that people want to turn to?
Well, I don't think that the helicopter sharing is going to be noticed very much by viewers. I mean, if you have 10 helicopters in the air shooting the same fire down below, it's all going to look like the fire down below, with the exception of maybe the smoke shifting right or left. It's the same same thing. And so I think a lot of the stock footage you see, there's already a sense of sort of sameness to television news, local television news, I think, right now. Anyway, you see a lot of the same video. There was an exception last night, actually, where Channel 7 had some video. They arrived early at the scene of the crowd chasing a shooting suspect in Dorchester, and so some compelling video. They opened the newscast with it, and you wonder, would that ever be something they would ever want to share with anybody else? But local stations, I think, are going to be downsizing, no doubt, and they have to, I think, start looking for things that are signature pieces, different types of coverage, enterprise stories that their competitors aren't doing.
You know, the helicopter arrangement doesn't trouble me at all, but as you say, it's likely to be a next step toward combining resources in ways that I think are more harmful to viewers. The helicopter is a huge expense, and I mean, at least theoretically, this could free up some money for some actual journalism, although who knows whether that's really going to happen or not.
Oh, I was going to say, as I mentioned, you know, a few weeks ago, and we talked about this in terms of the Chicago pooling of resources. You know, in the past 10 years, there's been almost a 20% decline in viewership of local news. So as you were saying, it's sort of an inevitable thing that's going to happen. It's interesting, too. I was at the New England Center for Investigative Reporting, which Joe Bergantino, formerly of CBS, now heads up.
And ABC.
What Oh, right. And what is so interesting is that they have gotten so many media outlets to sign on as partners, you know, because they want the stories that are coming out of this, because they frankly probably don't want to assign the people themselves. And yes, they have to provide a cameraman sometimes, or they have to provide resources to the center, but they get a lot of their work done by other people.
CBS 4, ABC Network. On the Liz Walker thing, though, you know, I find this fascinating. Her show is sponsored, fully paid for, I believe, by Blue Cross Blue Shield. I mean, I was suspicious it was going to be some kind of an infomercial. They insist it's not. But, you know, it's paid for by them. I don't know how, you know, it's living with, I don't know who her patients are or who her people are or how that works. But I find it fascinating that they're putting it in the Chronicle time spot.
Yeah, I think so, too. That says that they really believe in it and they want to give it a shot. That's what it says. I mean, listen, that's a place you should know better than me.
Or there's money
there.
Well,
there's money there, but they've also grown some local talent in terms of local shows. And, you know, looking at, Chronicle is a perfect example of that. There are very few places you can go in the country to find a program so finely produced that has beats the competition and has, you know, good stuff that year after year after year. So I think that maybe an attempt.
See, I take it as
direction.
An onerous sign.
Maybe. I don't know.
Except that Chronicle is largely about living better, vacation spots, you know, good places to eat. So it could potentially fit in if she talks about, you know, losing weight, you know, and the kinds of things that I think people are actually quite interested in and very often tune into.
I think it could be very difficult for her to establish a beachhead, given that, four times a year. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, you're up against a very successful show, and you're doing it so irregularly that,
people
they're going to have to do an awful lot of promotion to get people to change the channel those nights.
Well, Chronicle gets a decent rating no matter what.
She's a beachhead. Yeah. She's got a name in this town, so.
But you have to know she's on.
Well, that's true.
Well, you're turning into Orange Chronicle, and she's there. That's what they're hoping.
There you go. Okay.
Which is why it's not on Sunday morning at 7:30.
Okay.
All right. That's it for Beat the Press. Now you can make comments and suggest topics on our new website, beatthepress.org, or just email us at greaterboston@wgbh.org. Monday, an encore presentation of Memoirs. For all of us, I'm Emily Rooney. Good night.